Okay, so let's start off with endocrine physiology. Communication between cells. Endocrine is associated with hormones, which are released into the bloodstream. Unlike neurotransmitters, neurotransmitters are associated with the nervous system. Different glands that we need to know for the endocrine system include hypothalamus, pituitary, thyroid, thymus, adrenal glands, pineal gland, parathyroid glands, heart gland, or the glands associated with the heart, kidney, digestive tract, pancreatic islets, and then the gonads. So let's do a little bit of review. I like to use this mnemonic, Christ. We'll be covering a lot of mnemonics for this chapter. Christ stands for CNS, hypothalamus, releasing hormones, important gland, which is the pituitary, also known as the master gland, stimulating hormones, and target organ or target gland. So the CNS is part of the nervous system. Hypothalamus is also a part of the nervous system, but it's also the transition point. Because it makes hormones, it's a part of the endocrine system as well. So endocrine, again, was the release of hormones into the bloodstream associated with controlling different organs or different structures in the body. Hypothalamus, a really fun way to remember this is when you're high on pot, you're hungry, right? You're thirsty. You're basically a great consumer. But in addition to that, sometimes you're sleepy. Sometimes maybe you want to have sex, you're horny. And when you have sex, you get a little hot, so deal with temperature. So the hypothalamus has five major fun functions that I'm going to test you on. There's more than that, but for the purpose of class, we're just going to stick with these five, in addition to the hormones that you're going to learn. So sleep, sex, hunger, thirst, and temperature regulation are five functions of the hypothalamus. Hypothalamus releasing hormones. These hormones act on the pituitary to cause them to release stimulating hormones that act on the target organs. Okay, let's move on to the hypothalamus and the pituitary and what hormones come from the pituitary. And then we can do a quick review of the image you guys just saw before I flipped over to this. So, hypothalamus acts on the pituitary using different types of releasing hormones. The pituitary has two parts to it. It has an anterior pituitary portion and a posterior pituitary. Mnemonic to use for that is my flat pig is a posa. My flat pig is a posa. It stands for MSH, FSH, LH, ACTH, TSH, PRL, GH, and then the two hormones that are released from the posterior pituitary, not made by the posterior pituitary, oxytocin and ADH are actually made in the hypothalamus in the paraventricular nucleus and the supraoptic nucleus, but it's sent down to the posterior pituitary where it's stored and released. My flat pig, these hormones here are made, stored, and released from the anterior pituitary. So let's review. What does MSH stand for? MSH is melanocyte stimulating hormone. It acts on melanocytes, which are cells that hold melanin, to release melanin, and melanin is the brown pigment in the skin. FSH and LH are both acting on the gonads, which are the ovaries and testes. FSH stands for follicle stimulating hormone. LH stands for luteinizing hormone. ACTH is adrenal corticotropic hormone. TSH is thyroid stimulating hormone. PRL is prolactin. GH is growth hormone. O again was oxytocin, A was ADH. ADH stands for antidiuretic hormone. So diuresis is, if you go to Starbucks or you go to a coffee shop and you drink too much coffee, you end up peeing a lot, right? So that's diuresis. Antidiuresis is the opposite. Instead of peeing everything out, you're actually holding on to all the liquid. So I consider ADH to be a water conservation hormone. Let's move on and actually simplify this. MSH was simple. We said that acts on the skin to encourage the release of melanin. And melanin is used for skin pigmentation to protect against UV rays. FSH and LH, for now, we're going to just keep it simple and we say that it acts on the gonads. When we hit the reproductive system, then we'll be a little bit more specific on what their functions are. In the gonads, what are the two gonads? We have the ovaries, and then we also have the testes. FSH and LH can be associated with ovaries and estrogen, as well as testes and testosterone. ACTH is a fun one. ACTH, adrenal corticotropic hormone, acts on the adrenal cortex to release some hormones. We'll talk about that later. The adrenal gland itself almost looks like a Dorito chip. There's two layers to it. There's the cover, and that's called the adrenal cortex. And then there's the middle, which is called the adrenal medulla. The adrenal cortex releases some hormones. We'll discuss that in a bit. The adrenal medulla releases some neurotransmitters. And we should be able to get to that when we cover autonomic nervous system. TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone, acts on the thyroid gland to release T3 and T4. T4 has more, even though T3 is more potent. T4 has more. So PRL acts on the boobies or the mammary glands to encourage milk production. Growth hormone acts on every cell in the body, but for class, we're going to take a look at how it affects the bone. I can either have an overabundance or I can have an underproduction or underrelease of growth hormone, and that can affect the bone in different ways. Oxytocin and ADH. Oxytocin acts on the boobies, right, the mammary glands, and the uterus. It, a fast way for me to remember it is, it ejects the milk, it ejects the baby. And then again, we said ADH, antidiuretic hormone, acts on the kidneys for water conservation. It helps to reabsorb water if you're in a state of, let's say you're in a desert and you don't have access to water, you want to conserve as much as you can. So let's do a little bit of review. Hypothalamus, what are some of the functions of the hypothalamus? SSHTT, sleep, sex, hunger, thirst, and temperature regulation. Pituitary gland is also known as the master gland. What are the hormones that come from the anterior pituitary? My flat pig. What are the hormones that come from the posterior pituitary? POSA. So my flat pig is a POSA. What is MSH? Melanocyte stimulating hormone, FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, LH, luteinizing hormone, ACTH, adrenocorticotropic hormone, TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone, PRL, prolactin, GH, growth hormone, O, oxytocin, A, ADH, antidiuretic hormone. Good. So let's take a little break and then we'll come back in a little bit.